Radiant Team Ban. Fanatics turn to ban. Radiant Team Ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Fanatics turn to pick.
The sack.
Radiant team pick.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the BTS SEA series. Time for Fnatic versus Trust best of three. D, I'm joined here by...
Hello.
Hey, buddy. How's it going?
Your introduction today, so weak.
I think the match speaks for itself.
5 seconds remaining. So you're saying it's a boring match?
No, I'm saying it's a good match.
Yeah, but why are you not energetic? Haven't got your Red Bull?
I have my coffee. I'm sipping.
I think you have very bad coffee.
Alright. I'll blacken it up. Here we go.
You need an espresso.
Alright, so for those who are just joining us now, it's a single elimination, best of three. Fnatic takes on Trust. Winner moves on to play TNC, who already advanced yesterday. And guaranteed in the money. So best of three. Game one. Fnatic coming in pretty hot winter. They just got done finishing first place in ESL. They will be coming to New York and... looking, I wouldn't say perfect, like this team definitely feels like they have room to grow, but solid so far.
I was busy trying to finish my homework. I was watching all the games on the VODs because I didn't catch them. But I was watching the last game, up until the last game against MEP. And I think the two games that I lost yesterday, I don't know if you catch all the games, but I think the two games that I lost are mostly... hero picks wise, MEP have a much better strategy in both the games. If both the teams have very solid strategies, Fnatic will be able to beat MEP quite convincingly. So I'd say if they need to sharpen up their picks much more if they want to do well at ESL New York.
Do you think like that's more just Fnatic is a bit stronger now in terms of their form, or do you think like they have a higher ceiling compared to MVP?
I think they have a higher ceiling, but sometimes I know Mushi, he's very stubborn with hero picks, I'm sure you know, like from watching him since so long ago. He tends to be sometimes really stubborn on certain things with his hero picks, and it makes the whole team have less room for error, you know. Sometimes they have those sort of drafts where we say, oh, they have very little room for error. You know, we hear this a lot, of Fnatic drafts, they need to do well in the early game, otherwise they're screwed.
I mean, where do you differentiate between like a Mushi and a PPD, right? Because besides the results, like it's the same idea. You have to be a very confident leader. You can't just hope that, you know, your team maybe believes in you, but if they argue with you, then, you know, you'll just blindly adjust. Where do you like draw that line between confidence as a captain and also still giving your team like a voice?
It's difficult though, because balance is like you have to listen to your teammates. At the same time, you have to be confident in your own picks, you know, you have to know what you're doing. So I think it's very hard. It comes a lot with when the team grows together for quite some time and you get more understanding between each other, you grow the trust. I think it's difficult to just say, oh, you have to have this sort of balance between your teammates and whatnot. I think every team is different. With PPD's team, I guess he sort of decides a lot of the things that he wants to pick and play. Maybe with Mushu is the same, but his picks and bans sometimes, you know, can be a downfall to his team. Sometimes, not all the time.
All right, let's take a closer look at Fnatic here, Winter. Mm. So they open with the Lesh, the quick Wyvern Clockwork reply from Trust. Then they go back into a Quap here.
Yeah, the Queen is weird though. That was Lina. Lina was definitely 100%, I think, a better pick in the second. The second pick here for Fnatic. I'm not saying Lina is much better than Queen of Pain. I mean, it's still a much better hero than Queen of Pain in a lot of departments. It's just that the flexibility of the draft, you know. Because you have a Lina plus Lesh. It's much more flexible than Lesh plus Quap. Because Lesh plus Quap, it definitely means that either you're going to run, if you want to switch things around, you have to run Queen off lane or Lesh support, which both of the options are not ideal. Whereas you compare it with a Lesh plus Lina, your options are much more, you know, you feel much better with your options. Mm-hmm. Lina dual lane, off lane is much stronger, and Lina middle is strong. Lesh safe lane is also strong, so you have much better options, and the options you have with Queen of Pain and Lesh is not that great. But
what do you think about this though? Like, you've got literally like very target banned heroes through four bans for Trust, especially the Void ban second stage. That is 100%. We saw your games in ESL, and we're not going to give you your Void Lesh combo.
You look at what they were banning as well. So because they ban Void. The Void came after the anti-mage ban as well, so both of the teams are just banning out, like, maybe they are guessing you want this certain carry and they are banning it, like, they are both banning their carries, the carries that would be strong in their matchup, and I think that anti-mage and PL are two of the best heroes that Trust can play, and Trust probably wanted to pick, if you want to pick AM, right, you ban, Void is really good against AM. So
who do you think Laquelle should play at this point? Like, with Lina, Lina's already picked up, not
Water,
his hero.
Waterman.
The Morphling? Morphling, Ancient Apparition duo, perhaps?
Maybe, I think Waterman or, let's say, Dusa could be good.
Waterman. You, like, saying it funny. The Bounty Hunter gets picked up by Trust, they're going to hide the Laquelle's pick until the final.
This
final
guy
selection.
Is still here. Usually you see Lina Bounty Hunter first two picks.
Hmm.
Okay, whatever. But they still get the Lina plus... This, I think, personally, like, out of all the openings you can get, like, maybe Gyro plus Bounty Hunter, Gyro plus Earthshaker, Lina plus Earthshaker, Lesh plus Earthshaker, I think my ultimate favorite is Lina plus Bounty Hunter. I think this is my absolute favorite because it sort of solidifies the Lina pick as a core. And it makes the makes Lina like a... Lina is already a super strong hero, right? Bounty Hunter makes Lina like go imbalance in the game. Because you are so much stronger, you get more items faster. And it helps the Lina so much in the early game, you know? Because Lina, you are always scared of ganks if you don't get a good early game. And Bounty Hunter is there to make sure the game goes very well for Lina. And this Lina pick is, I think it's a sort of a good way, you know. I think at TI we sort of talked about it. Sometimes it's a good way of countering the curse because of the GA.
Interesting. But it is definitely Fnatic out of their comfort zone in some ways here. They will not get like a clear go-to black hero. Yeah. They do pick the Omni.
It's not very good versus Lina though, I have to say. Honestly.
The Repel, you mean, yeah.
Yeah, I mean the GA, it doesn't do anything against Aghanim's. Well,
hey,
I guess
congratulations on your magic immunity. I have pure damage.
Yeah, I guess nothing does really well against Laguna, except for Lincoln's. And if you look at what they have now, I think one combo that's really underrated is the Repel on the Look At It Go. You know, that's actually very scary.
Do you think this is a Fnatic Medusa game? They ran it a lot, and actually I was casting Mineski at first TNC, and they just start picking Medusa. I'm pretty sure they had just happened to watch the Fnatic series, like, this hero could work. But it didn't seem like the hero was really the go-to option in that series.
Honestly, I think it is an option. Like, Repel, I think Repel Medusa is like some old school thing, Dota 1 thing. I don't know if you actually recall seeing this a lot before, but back in the Dota 1 days, you have a lot of... Okay, alright. Radiant team pick. They banned the Medusa themselves, so they were also thinking of the same... thing that I was figuring that Trust might actually go for the Medusa, because you banned...
Oh, okay.
It's anti-mage PL gone, so the next best thing is probably Medusa.
Well, you said we were talking about the Waterman, but is it still really a Waterman game? I don't think so.
You split push the Omni Knight. Omni Knight wants to fight, you know. But okay, this is weird.
I feel like the teams are like, let's have a weird draft game.
This is not exactly something you want to go against Omni Knight.
What goes really well with Omni Knight, Winter?
Storm.
Storm's pretty good. Huskar is, not versus Lina, I guess. Not so interesting. Huskar. What else?
Not versus Lina, not versus each other. I don't know if they'll run a carry Omni Knight, though. I know sometimes team actually want to run carry Omni Knight. Because you look at their lineup, it's weird if you put Omni Knight support now. Don't you feel that it's much better maybe Omni Knight carry and they have stronger lanes like... Because Omni Knight can be a self-sufficient carry and then they can do some maybe a jungling sanking net sanking with Omni Knight repel.
Windranger? Yeah, I don't know. They need like... If they want it to be a support, they need a third strong laning core.
There's no defined hero here. You know, you don't know what Fnatic wants to go. There's no one hero. Oh, they're going to go for this hero and it's really good. There's no such hero right now. There's a lot of directions. They can go for gazillion things right now and... We are not in Mushi's mind, so...
One up! Called
well
it!
Well played! Larry David, well played!
I've been so training at your knee for some time now, Winter.
It's,
Mushi Windranger. Okay. There you go.
So, offlane Queen. Yeah, that's what I mentioned, when you open with Lash Queen offlane. The Queen offlane is, like, most likely an offlane.
I like the draft from Fnatic, not even saying, like, the overall composition is good or bad, but I just like the fact that they open Lash Quap, and I don't think Mushi decided until that pick what the role of the Lash was. Like, it was always open. And then the Quap can rotate between 1, 2, or even 3 position, like you're pointing out.
Honestly, I actually like Trust lineup more, even though okay, Juggernaut against Omni Knight is like.
Is it just the Lina effect here, or what do you think?
Yeah, Lina Bounty Hunter is so strong, you know. It's I can't really stress how strong it is. It's like one of the crazy combos you have right now in Dota 2 right now. You have Wyvern Pucks here, Bounty Hunter plus Lina. These are the three, in my opinion, top combos like. A pairing. I shouldn't say combo, but just pairings, you know. Hero pairings that are very strong in the meta. And they have one of it now. Lina plus Bounty Hunter.
What, if you're Fnatic, like, how do you... What's your, like, best play to counter that? Do you camp mid with the Omni or the Witch Doctor? Do you gank?
They just win their lanes, though, because right now, like you mentioned, they have a Queen of Pain offlane, right? So they can actually do... It's a melee call, Juggernaut plus. I want to say Wyvern in the safe lane, and Bounty will be freestyle doing his own stunt thing in the map. So you can actually run Queen of Pain plus Witch Doctor. There's a possibility that the Queen Witch Doctor will actually make sure that the Juggernaut doesn't farm.
All right, Winter, we get underway. Best of three, Fnatic. I would say coming in warm, maybe not hot. They were not totally dominant in their ESL finals, but they do advance. They go to New York, and with that, we introduce them. Net will be your offlane Omni Knight. DJ, the new upstart on the Queen of Pain. Mushi, going to be playing the Windranger mid, Ohio. Support Witch Doctor now. He has changed up the role with the introduction of Black, and that leaves Leshrac being handled by Black, Ohio, rather, on the Witch Doctor.
Oh, you definitely need more coffee, dude. So on the Radiant side, you have Abba playing the offlane Clockwork. On Trust, MyPro on the Lina, Feimal or SD playing the Wyvern, Lakels on the Juggernaut, and lastly we have Kaneki on, okay, QQQ, whatever, he wants us to call him QQQ, on the Bounty Hunter.
I don't know, that's a legendary name. Are you allowed to just say like, yeah, I want you to call me Burning now? That's my name, I'm a carry player, here we go. Alright. The first rune will spawn. Bottom lane, there's a 2-on-1 elsewhere. It's a danger for Mushi here, Mushi who's been slowed down just a little bit, and now they stun him out of Wind Rain. Escapes and will end up going down. Meanwhile, bottom lane, Lakel's also retreating, tries to tango through 1-2, but may not be in time. He ends up going down to the double auto attack, and a 1-for-1 around the map. The bounty runes, 1-for-1 as well, so first blood, signature trust, slightly on top.
Yeah, that was a really, really good... good kill on Mushi. That's, I think they got a much more valuable kill because the mid matchup gets affected more if you get a kill compared to trading your Juggernaut. I think mid matchup is something that is much a little bit more important than losing your safe laner. So the laner should have a much better time here in the middle lane. And looking at the dual lanes, it's actually not Witch Doctor Queen, it's actually going to be Omni Knight plus Queen. It's still fine, they're still going to be able to do a lot in this lane.
They do. Blade Fury here on Lekels will pop it rather early. They know he's got the degen are actually almost enough for the first, well, the first kill in the lanes, not the first blood, but...
You were so freaking
I mean, come on, it's been 1 minute and already we've got two kills and more attempts.
Alright, I fucking
Well, how generous.
You need to have time before your...
The caffeine is working its magic, Winter.
Sometimes, no matter how much caffeine you take, it's worthless.
Are you saying you can't cure stupid?
No, but there's gonna be a point where the caffeine is not working, you know, when you have too much of it.
Alright, I'm pacing myself here, but... Well, we will see QQ rotating towards the top lane. Ohio's in position here, but I actually see him run past the sentry ward, I don't think. Ohio, Black, sitting back. Not actually going with Abba just yet, but kind of fishing around while... Early on, it is the Lina, my pro with the first blood and involvement, and now starting to dominate Mushi a little bit. 5 denies already, Winter, but he might end up going down here. Throws out the slave. Oh, the power shot's gonna miss. That could be trouble. There's a stun. He does connect. Oh, close call, man. He almost dead.
He kept stopping the animation of the stun, and he realized Mushi was trying to dodge it, and he cast it at the best possible moment because Mushi wanted to go for the last blow.
Yeah, Mushi almost outplayed the hell out of him, but my pro does pull it out in the end. And
damn, that was such a clutch play.
Yeah,
but Mushi, we have to remember Mushi. The power shot,
so. Heavy damage done here. There is another slave. Can't really commit too much, and the bottle.
The lane is not working as well as I thought. That's why I felt Witch Doctor plus Queen of Pain would actually be better than Omni plus Queen of Pain. Juggernaut is actually getting quite good farm, despite losing his life at the first bounty rune.
Elsewhere, Abba taking a lot of Maledict damage, Abba. But QQQQ comes in, tries to turn it, doesn't have the firepower.
Can we just call him Kaneki, his normal name?
No, I'm gonna say it every time, just because I can. Not gonna save his lane mate.
Okay, I guess I have to use the same name as you're using.
QQQQ. Mushi now salving out mid, but... I mean, eyes on my pro, so, Winter. He's really dominating. You
know, there's QQQ, there's QQQ, and there's this guy, QQQQQ, and there's C that Q.
Who's QQ? Who's the double Q?
Imagine if all three of them in the same game.
Yeah, they got many of the Qs.
And then the opponent is DDC, DDZ, long DD.
And DD, just regular DD as well. All the Ds. Man. Mushi is holding the line mid though as quadruple Q walks through. My pro gonna rotate towards the top room, but too late. Ohio's already grabbed that invis and Abba back off here. Oh, maybe not. He's in a bit of a dangerous position. Ohio thinking about the go, but only has the level 1 Maledict.
If the Lash runs up right now, it'll be obvious something is wrong, you know. If you're the clockwork, because the Lash suddenly doesn't want to take last hits in the lane, so.
Quadruple Q rotating in. DJ does have the blink and.
Quadruple Q. Okay,
quad Q.
I'll try that. Okay, quad Q.
Also, let's eyes go, on top for Ohio is going now with the cast. The Maledict as well. Stun's gonna connect. Abba will be a next kill in this game. First blood long since acquired, but 2-3 the score and.
Patience.
That
was
he
so
really
patient,
camped
you know,
that top lane.
Because if they would have. Because if they would have done it earlier, like I mentioned, when the creep was like here, it would be obvious, right, when the Lash runs up that the clockwork knows what's going on. But because they did it later into the lanes when the second wave came in, so the wave was a bit higher, so the clock, it wasn't so obvious that something was going to happen to him, so he was trying to get experience like usual, and he got caught by the Witch Doctor.
Winter, you talked about mid-lane, the Lina Bounty Hunter, and I feel like so far this Bounty Hunter has definitely worked out. He's gonna get the courier, quadruple Q on the run. Mushi has centuries. Is he gonna drop one just barely? But there's a fog of war issue here. And quadruple Q, they turn it with the lead. Lacuna Mage end up killing Mushi off the bat. Yes, they do. My Pro brings him down. Now turning onto Ohio. They're diving this Witch Doctor. Already a level 4 bounty. They rotate in so many extra heroes. Now three non-mids trying to turn this. Lina's stun covering the path of retreat. Black should get the My Pro kill, but the bounty hunter will squeak away as the dust will wear off momentarily here and on cooldown for some time.
They would have gotten both the kills if he landed his stun, but too bad. They still got them one kill at least. But right now, let's see who is going to be able to TP top. Black might want to wait for the Witch Doctor to come back. No. He's just going to go to the lane. But right now, the Bounty Hunter plus Lina is just definitely doing so much work towards the Windrunner still. Okay, Windranger still doesn't have.
Okay. You're like, I hate this name, but I have to say it.
I hate quadruple Q, but I have to quadruple Q.
Oh boy. Winter, let me ask you. So Abba's about to hit level 6 here. He's doing pretty well in the offlane, and over on the Dire side, you've got the level 5 and a change Queen of Pain, so they're even on the offlaners here, but do you see the Quap being able to gank, or is she just going to like look to sit here and get farm?
I think you, as Quap, you want to gank only when you have your ultimate, right? So you're going to wait until... And you mostly play reactionary, right? Or TP scroll, and you wait for something to happen before you TP in. I think during TI, Sebastian actually mentioned this a lot. He always talk about whenever you pick a Queen of Pain, not on your team, you always have this sort of unseen pressure towards the opponent. You know, when the opponent tries to dive your other lanes, in 3 seconds, if you don't get the kill, you're gonna be screwed because the Queen of Pain will be TPing in with the Sonic Wave and Fan, and you're gonna lose heroes. So I think playing that style instead of trying to be so proactive on roaming might actually be better this game, because you want to shut down and pressure the Juggernaut as much as you can. You don't want to try to be too offensive and try to look for kills, and then the Juggernaut sees, oh, the Queen is missing. What else can the Queen be doing? He's going to be looking for kills elsewhere. So it would then be obvious, and the chances of you failing the game would be much higher.
How about the Windranger? This is normally a hero that like breaks even mid at least.
This is bad because of the Bounty Hunter. Again, the Bounty Hunter, I remember the other day, I'm not sure, was it BTS or ESL? Mushi got like so
I think
much
it was
problems
ESL.
In the middle lane against the Bounty Hunter. The Mineski the Mineski game, because they misplaced the Sentry Wards. So this game, I think once the clock hits level 6, the Omni Knight is like babysit 24 hours, 24/7, next to Mushi. Otherwise, Mushi gets hooked.
Black totally caught out here, but he might end up killing them with the Pulse Nova going. It's close. Oh, it's close, and it's a win with Ohio rotating in. Not respecting the Shrek.
100 damage a second is no joke.
Especially because he already had it on before they engaged. Like, that was... He toggled it. He sees the clockwork running towards him, and the Bounty Hunter is already tanking it before he even right-clicks. Radiant's top tower is
under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack. I actually forgot to mention, Feimao is actually the sub of the team. Noki is the official player.
Okay.
I don't know if you actually watch their games a lot, but Noki is Radiant's mostly the primary player. Hmm.
Yeah, I haven't seen them that much.
SD is like the coach, you know. He's like, he's always been their sub and coach.
The a bit of a lane swap up now as Feimao takes on the mid lane. The Tango, well, not even pull, just being born by quadruple Q here, going around towards mid. you can't even eat wards with that, right? Because it's not pulled to him.
Yeah, you can't. But finally, Mushi gets his boots. So. Man, it's 8 minutes in, and he just got his boots. That's how bad the game has
been. They're camping mid now. They want Mushi to come online. You know, the easy repel comes out, but...
they want Mushi to come online.
Mushi, please.
No, it's more like they don't want
Mushi
to die
anymore. They don't want him to go offline forever. Alright. Fair enough. Why are you such a flamer? Mushi's your brother.
I'm not flaming you, it's just... Okay, I'm a flamer.
Hasterin is up on my pro, and the Yule's almost complete, needing the recipe now. He's going to move into the Dire jungle. Vision, looks like they did see the Well, actually, no, that was the Radiant Vision. They don't see him coming. Ohio's in a lot of trouble here. So too is Black. They miss out. No problem. Laguna, see ya. Ohio now on the run. And my pro chasing a little bit. Has the stun. The Hulk's going to connect. Great play by Abba, but not chasing fully with the battery. So he's in on his own. Everybody else retreating out here. And looks like they will lose Abba immediately. Quadruple Q walking away. And my pro also retreating.
That's weird. As it sounds, that was actually worth it for Trust. As weird as it sounds, because you hook in, it's not a long cooldown, and now the TP from the Queen has actually came out, you know. So now the other lanes, once you see the Queen pop out in the lane again, the other lanes are actually feeling much safer because the TP is on cooldown. You know, it's weird to say that, but it's actually not that bad that the clock hook in into a bad position and force so much.
Do you think they should have committed more with that clockwork hook, or was that the better play to run?
The Lina didn't really want to go in though. So, and they didn't have mana on the clock because for the cogs, so he wasn't able to lock. Who was it?
It was Witch Doctor.
The Witch Doctor. In place. So, the Lina didn't want to chase into too deep. So he just like ditched. He tried to stun and then the stun missed and he just.
Yules is ready. There you go. Initiation. Now the stun follow up. Easy slave. No, Laguna. Again, just zapping fools.
Look at this.
My pro having a good time here.
Look at this. Yules starting to do work. The Lina being able to snowball that hard was going to do a lot of work.
Oh, mid lane courier might be in trouble. Quadruple Q hunting it. He's ignoring this potential kill of Mushi and now gets hooked. Trapped out completely. Mushi in way too far and has no escape plan. We'll end up going down again. Banatic just, they're hemorrhaging some big kills here on cores. Signature Trust looking to push.
This is still looking really, really bad because the Lina is going to be out of control, and I'm actually thinking this game, right, for the Lash, you might actually want to build a Lincoln Sphere on the Lash. Like, if you think about it, right, you're going to get repelled by the Omni Knight, and in the fight, you're only going to die by either, most of the time, the damage will come a lot from the Lina. So I think Lincoln's is actually a good build up for the Lash after the Bloodstone this game.
That's a bit of an unfortunate observer ward, though. We'll see if the Dire Squad even goes to their jungle. Lately, it feels like they're...
Yeah, honestly, where are you going to put the ward? Look, the three sentries can mostly cover...
It might actually not even get dewarded. It depends if they keep the pressure at bottom.
Yeah, actually, maybe
As I say that, he's going to immediately deward it. So, what I was trying to say, Winter, is this ward will be quickly deleted from the map.
And Mushi is going to be quickly deleted from the map.
No Omni Knight here to help him out. Just the Witch Doctor. Track comes out. This is a four-hero track takedown. They do lose one off the trade, though, as the Lina ends up going down. But it is a track kill for a non-track kill. DJ still sticking around here. It's a double track going. Triple track. Got to be careful that Shuriken. Quadruple Q will breed out. No detection on the Queen of Pain. Back out.
Claw is here with a hook shot though. They have so many tracks.
They can only clear a few of them at the time. Oh, the hook barely missing. Laquelle's gonna run in. Juking and jiving, not committing fully. The cogs, also not really wanting to go in here, and the Q will back out. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
So right now I think I think this is actually the last exchange, even though it was a track, at least they got a lot of gold, you know, they killed the Lina, so Fnatic in a much better spot compared to a few minutes ago. They tried the Shackle on Lakels, but not gonna connect. They're not gonna go 4-man while the Queen of Pain completes her use. I think she wants to get her use ASAP, so she can actually not be afraid of the Lina catching her out.
Now the ward wars begin here. Ohio's gonna deward the bottom lane, and with that, yeah, it seems like there's no way they can test this anymore, Winter. They will have to give the bottom tower up, and it's Black to get the last hit. Bloodstone already complete. Now 600 gold. He is farming very well.
Indeed. Like I mentioned, I still think Lincoln's, or maybe he will go for Yuz. I'm not sure. Yuz is still good. So Lincoln's is like maybe later into the game. It's a very good option for him to have. Mushi has gone for the double nose because he had such a nightmare game, or whatever you want to call it. I'm not sure what he wants to build next. I think 4 stuff could be a good option since he's in such a bad spot for him. Usually you don't want to go 4 stars on a core Wind Ranger, but this game he might be kind of forced into that situation.
Speaking of items, Lekels will go into the Mask of Madness here, so... It's squishy, but does have maximum attack speed and Omni-slash damage output.
I wonder if he's actually gonna go Diffusal this game. I actually wonder. Anyone is going to go Diffusal.
Well, if anyone's going to, it's either him or like the Bounty Hunter, I would say. Q. Is busy getting his mech for now.
That's
how it is to cast this guy. Sun comes out, Laguna's available, and will be used. Immediate triple track takedown. Fnatic just hemorrhaging kills here. Faimao, manned up, dying, but even then, it's not a track kill, and they've got the track going the other way. The Winter's Curse coming out, now he's gonna put himself under. Oh, not enough. Good effort. The double track now deployed. There's still an Omni Slash ready, though. They gotta be careful how they retreat. They dust. Oh, they're engaging.
Oh no, he might be dead.
Mr. Q dodging the stun simply by walking away. Still gets clipped by the lightning here. Where's the backup? That Omni Slash still ready, but Kel's simply not in position. We'll just settle for the Ancients. My pro. Kind of AFK split pushing top. It's an even game, Winter. Look at this graph. Just not even 1,000 gold differential.
Yep, it's a very tense game, but I think as the game, if the game keeps going like this, it's going in favor of Signature Trust because of the track. And right now, the Omni doesn't have his ultimate online yet, so once that gets online, I think Fnatic will be more keen to actually try to group out and push S5. Once they have it online, it's gonna be soon. He has a... wow, he has such an early gem. This is just, you know, net things, you know. He always likes to get a very... I'm not sure if he actually bought it or someone else.
No, it's his. It's his.
I think it's him. So he likes to, it's a play where I think I see it on him a lot. He likes to get an early jam as a support in certain specific situations so you can control the map. I think it's really good against Bounty Hunter. So you remove the vision and you are able to at least deal with some of his, you know, sometimes it gets so pesky that the bounty is always tracking you. Having the jam will actually not allow that to happen.
Meanwhile, Black has been given the jam. Now up to 10 Bloodstone charges and picks up a very cheap Glimmer Cape here.
Huh. This is weird though, Glimmer Cape against track. I'm not sure though. It's good versus the Lina until she gets the Aghanim. So, I mean, it's a cheap item though. So if it actually pays off right now, then it's fine. It's not like one of those few items that cost so much to build, and if it doesn't pay off, you invested so much on it. I think Glimmer Cape is an item that even if it's not, even if it's actually effective for 5 minutes after you buy it, it's already worth it. If it saves you a couple of times.
It's kind of like and a safer Yule Sister, yeah. Right? Where...
oh, Mushi is dead. Mushi is dead.
Is he? No, Rocket coming through. Mushi rotating towards the team. They're also backing off. Get the track on him. Long range choke comes in from Ava, but they're pretty in deep if they commit on this one. Downward, now deployed. Mushi will end up going down. Nice workers by Faimao. Covering the retreat, but already Chrissy on the rotation here. He's tracked up. Can they really do anything about it? Laguna already committed. They're going to blink out. They'll sink the clockwork, and rest of Signature Trust will end up backing out. I pro towards mid, and oh, one for one, Winter. But there was a track there.
Track. So, yeah. So you know who came out on top?
Doesn't require too much mathematical prowess at that point. Although, it was a pretty close kill, it looks like.
If they get the tower, then yes, it's okay for Fnatic. If they can actually get the tower. It looks like they'll be able to get it. Because Omni has level 8 now, has Guardian Angel, so they're very confident in pushing S5 right now. Maybe they're gonna back off, I'm not sure though. Because Mushi is not coming to the fight, and Clawwork already respawned for
some. Lekels looking for the Omni Slash here, but Chrissy would have a blink ready in just a second.
This might actually be bad for them.
Oh. If he blinked into the Omni, could have killed him, but... yeah, they're gonna retreat now with the Queen of Pain no longer top. A slight opening here, track coming out onto Ohio. Black even running back towards them, does get the stun off him. Quadruple Q to the target, instantly destroyed. Leshrek. Lekels looks for the backup here.
Want to surround them.
Could jump under now. Them. Can he get a good Omni shove? Ho coming. Ava actually hits his own teammate here, and Chrissy still hanging on to the ultimate for now. Can easily take down the clockwork if need be. Throws out the ultimate. No, maybe not so. He doesn't get the kill. No, Black in danger. Omni will kill him off. does not end up getting with the escape. Has the, I guess, instant respawn there from the Bloodstone charges. But none.
Huh. That was weird, though. They took a fight without... Mushi was, like, nowhere. And the queen TP'd to middle, so the queen was, like, running over towards top because the fight happened. I'm not sure why they still wanted... The first kill was fine, though, because they blacked, like, Glimmer Cape. He wanted to kill the bounty. He saw the bounty because there was a sentry, and he had a gem as well. So the first kill was okay, but then after committing for the first kill, they still wanted to fight. I guess they didn't have a choice after that because the hookshot came in. So going for the first kill resulted in them putting themselves in a position where Claude would actually be able to not let them escape. So the fight prolonged, and it was like, I think 5v4.
They do see MyPro rotating bottom lane. They had the ward off in the Radiant jungle. He's going to commit onto Mushi here. Make it the kill anyway. Has the Laguna available. Out comes the cast. Now the death ward. MyPro retreating rapidly. Didn't have the mana for the full combo. Oh. Ends up going down. A free kill. Fnatic. Very happy with that.
That was like sometimes players forgetting that the use cost so much mana.
Yeah, it used to be a really cheap ability, but now 175 mana.
Oh, here comes the Glimmer Cape. Oh, the gem. Oh yeah, he lost the
Black
gem, right?
First missed the stun, then probably with the kill. That's normally how these things work, and no, it'll be Perseus fix it, but still secured regardless. Two for nothing.
That's not normal.
No, that's like the shitty digest clip with Delina where she misses the stun, just Laguna's gets the kill anyway.
That was actually, we didn't actually mention about them losing the gem. That was huge, the last fight. Radiant's the gem is on the Wyvern right now. Still, Fnatic is able to use their 5. It's like they have to do this, right? Everyone has to be there to be able to take a tower. They can't repeat what happened the last time where they are not ready to take the fight. They need to be much more ready the next time it happens again. So do they have a medallion on anyone to get Roche? Let's see. Yeah, Doctor actually just purchased a medallion. They're looking to go for the Rosh sometime soon since they have managed to secure a good amount of map control. And I think you would want to put it on the Lash so you before you go for a high ground push. The Lash bought something. What did he buy? Huh, Blink. That's really aggressive.
Yeah, impressively, Fnatic Winter, they still have the tier 1 mid up. 22 minutes in. It felt like Signature Trust had the map control, but they didn't really translate it into too many objectives here. Mostly just a hero kill here, hero kill there.
Yeah, like a move at bottom, just now when Alina tried to kill Mushi, that sort of move, it's like, it slows down the tempo of the whole team, you know? It's not only a kill you are giving up, you're giving up a lot of other small things, like the whole tempo of the team gets slowed down because of that. But here comes Black.
Oh, MyPro again with the deep dives, but just blinking away. A bit of swag. He will retreat elsewhere.
A bit of yeah. Swag.
A little bit, you know, he's up in their grill. They're not punishing him. That's swag.
Okay,
and your question is answered. Yeah, we'll see the defusal on Laquelle straight away. It's the Asha, then right back into it. Casual winner's curse mid.
How does this work? So you have to... You're not gonna get the mana burn, right? If you pick up the Mask of Madness first, you're not gonna get the mana burn.
Yeah. It's not like Maelstrom where only if it procs...
Wait, he actually... So he's getting... Wait, what? He actually got the mana burn on the range.
Oh, did he?
Diffusal is not a mana burn.
Oh yeah, it's an orb anymore. The anti-mage mana burn is an orb exactly. Though, which is what's confusing.
Okay, so it actually works with his Mask of Madness. I mean, it's not a big deal, but it's purchased mainly for just to remove the repel here.
Yeah, it's... I'm pretty sure it got changed, so it's no longer an orb. Weird, like, you could combine almost all of the orbs, not quite, like... Maelstrom, Scotty is pretty much fine, because you only get the Maelstrom if it procs. You've got the lifesteal mana burn now is okay. The Scotty lifesteal is okay in general. It's kind of strange. It used to be very black and white, like most of the combos didn't really work.
Whatever. Dota is not about logic anyway.
We've got the anti-mage modifier, which I'm pretty sure is... I think I was just looking at today. It's still a unique attack modifier. Yeah. That's why you can only get flats on him, even now.
Anti-mage mana burn is different from the rest.
Like you said, who said Dota orbs were based on logic? Definitely not the frog.
So here comes the smoke. They want to actually get a pick off and then go rush here. So this is key. They want to get a kill, get a rush after that. So if they can actually find a key target, anyone would be nice. Actually, the highest reward target is the Wyvern because he has the gem. Their gem.
Yeah, well, Fnatic, gem or no gem, right into the Roche pit here. They went for a bit of a smoke wraparound, but Radiant team gets eyes on this. They have the hook shot available. Are we going to see the big plays coming out from Mr. Abba? Net trying to body block this. He's looking to screen the shot, but it's tough to know. They don't have vision up the hill right now. He could still commit for this one. Is he going to go at the right moment? Oh, too late on the rocket.
Okay, I think he's glad he missed the hook shot.
That was an incoming feed there. Incoming feed will be coming. Sapa gets caught by the Eagles into the chain. Nuke and down he is.
Okay, so that's just Fnatic making use of their 5-man. Their 5-man is much stronger. So they are able to get the Roche and... I still think Lincoln's is good though on Lash, even though Black still hasn't showed any signs of purchasing it this game. I think Repel, Lincoln's plus Repel is something that is super strong.
Yeah, I mean, at that point, what do you... You have Winter's Curse and Omni Slash. Well, I guess Laguna...
Now is the time where you consider it.
Yeah, I guess you have three ways to target Magic Immune Heroes.
Yeah, but all the three things apart from Omni Slash where you block only the first slash and the rest here. So I guess the other two, the curse or the Laguna, is a pretty big spell to block still. So I think it's still a very valuable item to purchase on Lash in this particular scenario, not all the time obviously.
Attic are gonna back off after securing the Aegis for Black and clear out the top lane. It looks like Creeps in general pushing pretty hard for them. Bottom lane push past the river, middle lane at the river, and top lane a 4-hero contingent to shove it out. Do you think Fnatic go for any big objectives here, Winter, or is this just more of a defensive like farming stage for them?
I'm trying to click on the heroes, let's see. What do they... Are they still lacking on gold or anything else? I don't think so, right? Everyone has all their money spent on everything. And Witch Doctor has a new gem, so I think once you get this gem, you move around, you take one walk in your park, which is your own jungle, and you don't see any wards, and then you group up after that. That's just about it when you get a gem. You don't want to get pickoffs when you get a gem, so you take a stroll in the park, your own jungle, you check there's no wards, so you group up immediately after that. No risk.
Well, they have taken the stroll, they have not taken the group up yet.
Soon, I think they're going to be heading top. There's no way they are not going to be heading top, I think. You just want to play around the Lash with the Aegis now. And the Lash has chosen to go for... I mean, Boots of Travel is still a core item on Lash, so... I'm still looking forward to see what he chooses to go for next as his item. Shiva is always good, but against Lina, you want to be more, you know... You want to have raw HP to survive, or you want to block. In this case, the Lincoln Spear. If you want to go for raw HP, it's Octarine Core for Lash. I think it's between the Octarine Core or the Lincolns now for Lash. Unless he decides to go for the Shivas, which is, I think, not so valuable compared to other two items.
Yeah, BKB is not the item when this Lina and Juggernaut Lina close to the eggs and Jug having items in general.
Yeah, they still don't have 4 stuff, yeah, against Clockwork? Yeah, they don't, because they've been busy buying gem. The first gem was on Omni, and the second gem was on Ohio, so that's a very sad scenario. Let's see if Mushi helps them out, maybe. The supports are not having a good time to actually purchase the 4 stuffs to help the core.
We'll have a bit of a prolonged pause here. Our Wyvern player disconnected. Still a very even game, Winter. Just looking at the numbers, there's a bounty hunter on the team that's losing, so makes it feel even more even. No base structure is really under any threat at this point. All T3 is full HP.
Yeah, and both the teams I think have very, very solid. Their late game is like comparable to each other. You know, there's no one team that, oh, when you look at their heroes, this team definitely has the edge when it goes to late game. I would say maybe when Omni gets Aghanim's, you can say that in the later part. But before that, I think both sides have quite equal lineups into the late.
Hour will drop top lane. Fnatic are gonna push in now to force the issue here. Mid lane initiation onto Abba, takes the Mac Shadow Strike slow. Now the Yule's coming out. This may set up for Fnatic. Out the power rod goes, and Black will secure the kill. Now up to 11 Bullstone charges. Mushi getting healed by Ned, and siege commences. No rotation yet from Lakels, and MyPro still off in the bottom lane. They're gonna give up this tier 2 tower mid lane. That's two tier 2s down, and with this, the third will fall. Fnatic, no outer towers on the Radiant side between them and a lane of Rax now. Question is, with the Aegis here, Winter, do they go high ground? Looks like they do.
The Juggernaut is actually pushing quite fast alone. So I'm not
Lakels
sure.
is level 16 now, has the level 3 Omni Slash, but Fnatic are committing for this. Another ultimate coming out, a Wind Ranger, and no glyph available any longer. They're missing a pill, and well, meanwhile, Lakels about to finish off this tower bottom lane. He's really ratting this one out nicely. Still, the Omni Slash has the Diffusal Blade in case somebody gets a little overzealous with the. Oh, no, TP's getting cancelled there. There's the Winter's Curse. Mushi caught out. Now the two heroes done. Beautiful play by MyPro. He's going to bring out one. Make it two. They've lost the Omni Knight. They've also lost the Wind Ranger. And Lakels just walking away. Could even go back in potentially if Black's not careful.
That was such a good decision making from Lakels. Forcing them, like, playing that situation absolutely perfect. He knows his team has, like, very good. And it was a very good curse to stop them from getting out. So, all in all, the whole team.
Did he glimmer in? Oh, my pro! DJ, nice play. Might even. Oh, he did. He did not snag the. Wait, where's the. Oh, the doctor gets the gem? So he'll grab it in the end.
The witch doctor bought another gem.
Before. Oh, the Wyvern. Wyvern also has one now.
Yeah, the Wyvern has one gem. They're both essentially Fnatic's gems, so.
They're not having the track gold, so it's a little more expensive to be buying multiple gems this game.
Say, let's see.
When the dust settles, they don't lose a lane of Rex here in the mid lane and bottom. Only a tier 3 caved in, but they weather the storm for now. Black's still holding onto the Aegis, though, and Timmy remaining has like 30, 40 seconds, and he's rushing in here. We go, sir. He's tracked up on the front lines. No Lina for about 8 seconds. Black quickly sieging. Was popped a level 4 edict and does a lot of damage to the structure, so no committing just yet. They don't have a Winter's Curse for 8 seconds. It might just be enough time here. Already almost dead. They get the Omni Slash. I'm on to Black exclusively, but it's right before the Aegis pops. That's not ideal for Lakels, as the Diffusal Blade has the BKB, can commit onto the Leshrac, who doesn't have his own magic immunity to get his way out of here. Just tries to pop the Glimmer Cape, looks to run, but Lakels has no mercy. My Pro will finish the job, and now it's Ohio. 3 dead, about to be 4. Fnatic getting cleaned up. They did take down a melee Rax, but boy, oh boy, it really cost them, and I'm just looking at this graph straight up.
Hello?
No thoughts on, huh?
Dude.
Was our call acting up?
It was a good curse. Yeah, I think my connection is. There's something wrong with my connection.
It's gonna sound like you were really bored with that fight because you just didn't say anything. I think you were talking, but nobody could hear you. So sorry about that, Winter.
No, I wasn't talking. I knew the call was like. The call dropped. So. Yeah, but like, that was a really good. I think the biggest thing that won them the fight is the three man curse there. And. The Juggernaut was able to use his Omni Slash to kill. He killed the Lash, the Aegis on the Lash, and
it almost looked bad. That, but they really don't have a good solution for BKB Jug, because it's not like they're just gonna wait for him to Omni and then, Focus Fire or save Quapple. Like, these spells will be used earlier. He just runs at them with BKB.
Yeah, that's why I feel like when you get the Lincolns on the Lash, you just run in with the Repel and you just do as much. The Lash didn't do so much in that fight because he couldn't.
What's the next item for Black here? He's got the majority of the team's net worth. Obviously, it's
really
in Black We Trust kind of game.
I really hope he's going Lincolns. I think Linkus is still a good item here. He has an op though, but I think he might actually go for Hex. I don't know. Let's see. Linkus or Hex. And Mushi still hasn't done anything so far. It's so late game though. I doubt he'll be in the 4 star. He's just probably gonna build damage items for his team.
Off towards the top side, my pro. Little guerrilla warfare here. Worms his way through the trees in Ohio. If you walk down that cliff, my friend, you may live to regret it. Ping coming out. Q. Q, Q, Q. Getting excited, but... Mushi will be the kill. Oh, even tastier for Signature Trust here. They do have the blink ultimate available, and now they set up. Stun coming, and... That Laguna... Oh, no mana. Oh, that hurts. Actually, man, to cause them here with the Omni Slash. That didn't have the combo. This is a surprisingly low mana. Lina, maybe this is where you need the Bloodstone. Lakels will go for the TP out. Can they cancel this? Doesn't look like it. End up just walking away.
Yeah, this is...
That looked really bad for a moment there.
This is why the... Yeah, this is why the team, a lot of players, when they talk about Lina, they like to get Bloodstone. Because with Bloodstone, you're allowed to be much more... what's the word? You can actually use your mana much more. You don't have to care about your mana, so you can just use it freely. But without the Bloodstone, and the Bloodstone also allows your farm to be much faster, so you actually get this. Maybe he got this items like about say 25, but with the Bloodstone, you can still get it about maybe just a couple of minutes later. So the Bloodstone definitely would be helpful in that regard. It speeds up your farm and increases your mana capacity.
Yeah, and it just feels like you farm a lot better. I think we saw an extreme example yesterday with... it was Cuckoo and Maneski who just, naked rush Bloodstone, to a fault. Like, AFK farm, never came to fights, but... My god, he had over 10 CS a minute. And it shows the power of the Bloodstone build, that you basically never have to go base on Lina.
Yeah, I think Bloodstone build is just underrated. Sometimes as a Lina, Lina is a hero that doesn't really need... Like, you have to identify the situations. This game, the early use was actually fine because he got so much pick-off and he got to a good start. But after that, he could actually go back for the Bloodstone. It's still a good option. And the answer is on... The answer on Lashrock is Lincoln's. Yeah, just got a Lincoln's.
It'll help a little bit, but they have track, they've...
A little bit? Dude, no, it's helping a lot. If you imagine you have to repel on in the fight. If you block Laguna, that's huge.
That's true. If they get it off, but Black is not repelled currently. Lincoln's will be propped off the bat. Now they get the Witcher's Curse off. It's on to DJ, though, who's fairly tanky, but Lakels just starts chopping with Omni Slash. Not even required as of yet. They just begin with the Laguna Blade. They force Black back, baiting out the Omni Knight ult. Now looking to retreat Signature Trust already with the one-man advantage. Black, gotta do a lot of work here, but the... will end, and Fnatic not getting the job done as of yet. Now the engage onto the Bounty Hunter, but is it worth it? Two hero stun, forced it forward, cog back to Mushi as well as Ohio. Now the Omni Slice, finally it comes, and no mercy from Lakel, slicing and dicing. It's three falling, and Appa hunting for the fourth. Ohio into the trees, no escape, no mercy. Signature Trust, slaughtering Fnatic. But mid lane, getting wrecked by the creeps.
They got a range wreck, so... Trust has to. There's no buybacks though. They're gonna get these racks. They have to get these racks. This set of racks. They should have enough time to get it. They should.
I mean, you mentioned the combo of the repel linkage, but it doesn't help when they don't use it right away.
Didn't get it off though. They didn't. Yeah, they didn't use it right away. And they lost the Queen of right at the
Lakels
start. Lakels
just casually Blade Fury dodging away from a Shackle shot. Don't think it would have latched anyway. He will jump out, but the Edict comes, and as that Blade Fury ends, he's completely certain. It looks like Lakels will go down. Did not clean up the racks. Very close.
I actually thought they have enough time to actually get the melee racks and just get out. But he probably shouldn't have, the Wyvern, he actually embraced. He embraced the Lina when they were sieging. Maybe if the Lina was actually right-clicking the racks, they would have actually been able to hit it and get out.
Yeah, I think you're right there.
They just needed, They needed
it
another...
It was like three auto-attacks. It was very little. Drupal Q will move out now. They bought back, committing the Juggernaut to this fight. He die again. Maybe an opening for Fnatic, but trying to force it. Juggernaut rotating in. Still a little bit of a ways off, but Fnatic also... Getting cold feet here. Looks like Chrissy will blink out. We'll retreat for now, but with the track going, Vaughn may have the vision advantage.
Yeah, and they have a four stuff, I didn't mention. They have a four stuff now on map, so that's very important for them. And let's see, the next thing to have is buybacks. Who actually has buybacks? No one, apart from Mushi. Yep, only Mushi has buyback.
Mushi is lacking for items at 40 minutes.
That is like 60 gold short of buyback, so you should be able to get it. And this is the point where you need to have buybacks on your, especially the Leshrac, since he has boost of travel.
Fnatic dancing around the bush. They managed to force that Lakel's buyback, but not going to stop him from walking into the pit. Confidently, he strides, begins to go to work, has the max blade dance here. Dire Squad seeing this coming. Ward's getting drew up now, and they may get the jump here. Mushi initiating, does not find a shackle shot. Actually does onto Abab. He's still in an okay position here, being healed up by the Cold Breeze. They committed so much to kill him off. Oh, Chrissy in the middle of the river, still not fighting a whole lot. Laguna will secure the first kill, but a left stun on a dude. Black running rough shot through signature. Is my pro now stun? Surviving for now. Lakels comes in, drops the Omni, goes to work with the blade. They're gonna lose my pro here, team. No, the cold embrace. He's still surviving. Can he get off another stun? Not gonna happen, but Black nearly out of mana at this point. Has the Blake Dagger available. Purged up, slowed down. Hook and kill. Abba also looking to rejoin this fight. He had fought back, so it looks like Black's gonna go down in addition to track kill. They're not done yet. They won Mushi. There's the alien ward. Mushi will try to finish off, but that split second of hesitation means Lakels will turn him in chop suey. And when the dust settles, it's a clear win here, it looks like, for Team Signature Trust Winter. Double dieback, but a quadruple dieback and a single dieback coming out for Team Fnatic.
Quadruple kill forces a quadruple buyback.
Exactly. Maybe some of the buybacks on the team that Fnatic weren't hoping for. Now they're going to commit to the Roche, and Fnatic, they've got no intention of contesting this. But mid lane, creeps are pushing in.
Man, that was so, so bad for them. Holy crap. They killed the... They weren't able to do enough damage, though, even though the Wyvern casted her ultimate on a singular target. Once the queen jumped in, he dropped the ultimate on the queen, and they were able to use... They used all their spells, you know, they used the Wyvern curse and they used the Laguna, but they still lost the fight because the Juggernaut was able to...
They've got eyes here on the Witch Doctor bottom lane. My pro going in, gets off the stun, onto Ohio, deletes him from the game courtesy of the Laguna Blade. Easy kill.
He can't restore himself. No buyback. Cooldown. This is big,
Rex. Actually. This he had the death ward as well.
Okay, so who else has buyback? Only the Lash, right? Oh no, Lash bought out as well. So no one has
buyback. Dire Squad, nobody has buyback. Three on cooldown, two without money.
That is bad.
But Lakels does not actually take it. Melee Rex stun attempted by Black, but it wasn't quite the right time. Lakels was still Blade Fury. Will spin away.
I think that they can actually... the melee racks as well. They are actually very, very scared. Trust is playing very safe. They have the Aegis and they have the Omni Slash on Juggernaut. They're maybe just waiting. Yeah, they're waiting for the Lina ultimate to come off.
I'm also surprised he's not spending his gold. He's got 7,000 and he bought back.
The curse. They can't push now, I think. They wasted the curse on Lincolns. Damn.
I mean, Lakels had 7k gold with no buyback and he did not want to spend it either.
Yeah, why are they playing so safe though? They had one hero down and they only killed the... They should have been able to kill the melee rats. Huh. Not sure though. So maybe he's gonna complete his... Let's see, what does he complete now? 7k. Abyssal, Skadi. These are the two items that come to my mind right away.
What's the Juggernaut really item here, do you think?
Yeah, I think he doesn't need so much lockdown. I think either will be fine. Either the lockdown or raw HP. He finishes SMY.
That's... I thought he was gonna build... Well, I guess he'll have buyback when it cools down.
Yeah, it's still okay. It's not really a bad option because it allows him to spend some of gold. And the second thing is he doesn't have to sell an item, right, by getting SMY. If he's getting a basher or getting Skadi, he needs to sell his item. So he probably doesn't want to do that and he just wants to wait for the Aegis to expire so he can actually purchase another item after that, so doesn't want to sell anything. I think it's still understandable.
It's the gotta go fast build. Lakels is always at max move speed here. That Mask of Madness active.
I thought you used to call that the race car build. Now you have, you changed the name, right? The gotta go fast build.
Yeah, I mean either or, you know. You get some move speed with both builds.
You get some move speed.
Emphasis on a lot. Up to 4,500 gold and...
Oh.
Well, I wish you could just at a glance check the track gold, because... I actually, it's only 29 to 22, but I feel like they have a ton of track gold this game. Leshrac gets 40 CS more than Nuggen. Barely ahead of net worth.
I think the next thing they have to do is get a boss, you know. Look at the middle lane, because they don't have the Rex, someone has to defend it all the time. So they, at some point, I think the Lina is a good candidate to get a Boots of Travel next. So he can help his team. Okay, repel on the ledge. So let's see if
they're baiting out the Quad Bolt there, and Creep still come marching in. Lakel's engaging. He's gonna Blade Fury immediately into the Rex. That Aegis wearing off fairly soon, but now Fi Mao engages. They have an Omni Slash available. Not using it on Black, just a Hack Slash attack, and will bring him down. That's track gold for the whole team, practically. Omni Slash still being held. Somebody deal with this Juggernaut. Doesn't even need an Omni. He still hangs on. Driving Netbag towards the well. Continues to hold the ult. Laguna even available. They just got two kills and almost two more. Forcing everybody back and going for the gold here, Winter. This will be the bottom racks, possibly roads on the mid quap now. Stunned up. Oh, defensive Yules trying to dodge this clockwork now, and a less than ideal hookshot. There's the shackle, won't connect. Lakels. Chop, chop. That's it. I mean, they're really wasting a lot of time going for these. No, net. Down he goes. Lakels now onto the top lane. They've taken bottom already. Ava may pay for this. He hooks his way forward, tries for the cogs. Not going to be enough to save his own life, but the space was created. Lakels still holding the Aegis and has like 4 seconds to go. Mush engaging. I just can't believe there's been no Omni Slash. He just sits here, right-clicking heroes. Who even needs the goddamn ult? Now he's going to pop it, and on it goes, clearing up Mushi. Just... a disappointing showing from him as Chrissy will have to blink away. And this will be two lanes of Rex. Quite possibly the game. Signature Trust. Dominant here in game number one.
He's BKB to get the Rex though.
Okay, he's got 7 point BK. This is getting a little absurd, Lakels. It's okay to buy an item here or there.
I thought he was going to just BKB to the Rex though. Because that's
the there's a Quap ultimate. They can get the kill here. Yep. There you go, well played, but 1,400 gold going the other way. Something for Fnatic. They also get Mao as well. No track gold on their side. And they are down two full lanes at this point. Very expensive.
One and a half lanes.
Alright, well, Melee, yeah, you're right. 1.5, but feels like 2.
Yeah, but Melee, yeah, it's more or less 2. So... man, the fights have been really one-sided right now, even though... Omni wasn't able to get... the last fight, it was really key, I think I didn't mention. The Lina blinked in right away when the fight started with the curse. The Lina did the best thing he team could have hoped for. He blinked in, he hexed the Omni Knight right away, which was, I think, the most crucial play in the last fight at the bottom racks. That was the fight. That was the play that won his team the fight. And they killed the Leshrac right away, and Lesh didn't have buyback, so they were able to just roll over that team fight.
Definitely was a game changer. they got... yeah. 2 kills and forced a third back to base without using Omni or Laguna. That was how the fight started.
They won the
are they going for it? Juggernaut does have a buyback. 4 heroes alive, Gloop available. Fnatic really trying to force that buyback out, and they will, but it comes maybe at the cost of Mushi here. Lina stunned a bit off the mark, but the quite a bit of damage done. And Clockwork will engage. Lakel's charging forward. Still is the Omni ready. Hanging onto it. He gets hexed up. He gets stunned. He now is Maledict. It's a dieback from Lakel's. This could be the difference maker. But MyPro forcing his way onto Mushi. We'll finish him off. Oh, now, good job there to clean up the kill. Comes at the cost of Abba, it seems. Yep, not enough. And now Q could be next. He tries to retreat. Not going to make it. Gem also ready to deck. 5 mal in danger. Everybody better buy back right away. My Pro retreating for all he's worth. Doesn't have a Laguna 17 seconds. Fnatic, do they keep on pushing him? It seems like they might be trying to just slam the GG button, but only one lane of rack properly down at this point. They're committing for the throne. They're going for it all. Abba Hook is ready. There you go. Lina gets pushed back and unable to engage. Hexed up as well. What a beautiful combination. Now the Quapple backstabbing the Lina, who immediately will return the favor by buying back and re-engaging. Abba heading on. My Pro in pretty far here. Abba will end up going down. It's a dieback as well. No Juggernaut for 45. Dota is exposed. Don't tell me Signature Trust lose this one, Winter. It seems it may be. It's getting dangerous now. Chrissy right-clicking for all he's worth. Blinks to the north. Hangs on for now. No Winter's Curse. There's a blink, a glimmer, but no lockdown of, to speak of. Lina does do it with auto attack. So Ohio will end up falling. Now the Hex, the turn onto Mypro. Can they force the triple dieback low in danger? Will end up going down. Almost not quite. Still surviving. Now the Yule Scepter has the Hex. Quad Bolt says no, but Juggernaut is getting back soon. They're running out of time here. They gotta finish this throw, and boy, they will. No! Fnatic! They got it. Oh. Signature Trust. How do you not win that? Fnatic slam the door. Oh, Winter, that was brutal.
You say why Signature Trust didn't able to close it out, but again, I think it was also a good decision making. We kind of have to credit Fnatic though. At that point, they chose to not get a second set of racks, but force the buyback. Because if they, I think if they were to force the top racks, right,